نحمده ونصلي ونسلم على رسوله الكريم أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ما كان محمد أبا أحد من رجالكم ولكن رسول الله وخاتم النبيين وكان الله بكل شيء عليما صدق الله مولانا العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين. After the praise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and salutations upon the best of creation, Hazrat Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I like to thank the custodian of the holy shrine, Darbar-e Aliya Gola Sharif, Peer-e Tariqat, Rehber-e Shariat, Peer Sayyid Mehr Faridul Haq Sahib Al-Gilani, Damat Barakatuhum Al-Aliya, who has given me the opportunity to share with you a few points on this very important subject, the finality of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which has been mentioned in this very famous ayah which I have recited, Khatam al-Nabiyyin. Today I'd like to first of all share with you the a famous book entitled by the name of Saif-e Chishtiyai, which was written by Ra'isul Mujaddideen, Sayyidul Sadat, Hazrat Sayyiduna Peer Mehr Ali Shah Sahib radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, a great scholar who were endowed with the exterior knowledge and the interior knowledge. Ra'isul Mujaddideen, a great scholar, and also from the family and lineage of the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Just to take you the reason and why Hazrat Peer Mehr Ali Shah Sahib rahmatullah alayh wrote the book Saif-e Chishtiyai on this subject, on the finality of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, a little bit of the background is that when the appointed date and time was prefixed and Mirza Qadiani didn't turn up at the place for the debate, he went back and he decided to write a book entitled by the name of Ijazul Masih, and he attempted to write the commentary on Surah Al-Fatiha, the opening chapter of the Holy Quran. Now when he wrote this book, and this book spread far and wide and went in the hands of great scholars and people who are very well versed in the Arabic language, they witnessed flaws and deficiencies and mistakes and many errors on various branches of the classical sciences which are taught in the curriculum, Dars-e-Nizami, namely etymology, syntax, logics, rhetoric, ma'ani, badi, and also many other branches of ulum and funoon which are taught in the classical sciences to understand the Quran and the hadith and the Arabic language. So then he, after this, he wrote another book attempting to reply to Hazrat Ra'isul Mujaddideen, Hazrat Sayyiduna Peer Mehr Ali Shah Sahib Rahmatullah Alayhi's book, which they had written previously, Shamsul Hidayah Fi Isbati Hayati Masih. And this book was written on the subject of Hayati Masih, which translates into the raising of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam to the skies alive, and as the Muslims believe over the centuries and from the beginning until this day, the consensus is that Isa alayhi salam was raised to the heavens, and he was not crucified, he was not slayed or assassinated. And this was the Ijma'ah Ummah. And Hazrat Rais al-Mujaddideen rahimahullah ta'ala had wrote this book previously before Sefi Chishtiyai. He had written this book, which is a masterpiece of work as well, on this subject. And this Mirza Qadiani had attempted to reply to this book, and he wrote a book called Shams-e-Bazigha. He himself didn't write this, but one of his followers, who one of his mu'taqideen, Mawli Muhammad Ahsan Amroi, he got him to write this book entitled by the name of Shams-e-Bazigha. Both of these books, which Mirza had, one he wrote himself and the second he got written, Ijaz-e-Masih and Shams-e-Bazigha, both of these books, Hazrat Ra'isul Mujaddideen, Sayyidul Sadat, Hazrat Bir Mehr Ali Shah Sahib, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, wrote the book Saif-e-Chishtiyai. Saif-e-Chishtiyai, the Chishti sword, which is, subhanAllah, appreciated by the very well erudite scholars who have very well versed in the Arabic language, who have studied the Arabic sciences, the Uloom and Funoon, and mastered and studied and taught these sciences, can really appreciate this book, which is a masterpiece of work by Ra'isul Mujaddideen rahimahullahu ta'ala, Saif-e-Chishtiyai. So Hazrat rahimahullahu ta'ala had written this book Saif-e-Chishtiyai answering against the both of the books, which Shams-e-Bazigha and Ijaz-e-Masih. Hazrat rahimahullahu ta'ala finally wrote this book, and in this book Hazrat rahimahullahu ta'ala had highlighted almost 100 places or more where Mirza Qadiani in his Ijaz-e-Masih had made errors and mistakes linguistically, literally, in diction, in etymology, in syntax, in logics, and he had taken many meanings and misinterpreted many words and meanings, and created iltibas, which is a term used in this art of tafsir, and he had also committed tahrif, changed the meanings, tarif-e-manavi. So and Hazrat rahimahullah ta'ala had highlighted and pinpointed all these areas where he had made these mistakes and made these errors. And in one place, Ra'isul Mujaddideen rahimahullahu ta'ala had pinpointed and highlighted 20 places from Ijaz-e-Masih where Mirza Qadiani had committed sarqa, forgery, where he had taken sections of Arabic text from Maqamat-e-Hariri, a very well famous book taught in our Dars-e-Nizami, and he had taken 20 places, copied them, and written them in his book, and he had related them to himself, that he is the author, he is the writer of these phrases, although he had committed sarqa, sarqatul ibarat. He had taken sections of Maqamat-e-Hariri, 20, and placed them in his own book and related them to himself. So Hazrat rahimahullah ta'ala had, alhamdulillah, by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and in one place, Ra'isul Mujaddideen rahimahullah ta'ala themselves, in a Persian couplet, they say, ta yafta am khabare azbabi ulume dil, that Hazur Kibul Alam rahmatullah alayhi says that my knowledge is from Babul Ilm, the door of knowledge, who is Mawla-i Kainat, Sayyiduna Ali al-Murtaza, Shere Khuda radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. And Hazrat rahimahullah ta'ala had been endowed with all these sciences. You can say that Hazrat rahimahullah ta'ala, besides the batni ulum, the interior sciences, the exterior sciences, Hazrat Rahimahullah Ta'ala had conquered, if I want to use this word correctly, mastered the sciences and reached to the level where he could application. Some scholars study the curriculum, study the different various sciences, but are unable to apply them in the Quran, whereas this rare, august personality, a unique man with man of Allah, with this great vision and this God-gifted ability, he could apply these principles of various sciences, Usul al-Fiqh, the principles of tafsir, commentary, logics, mantiq, the qawaid al-arabiyya, and the qawaid al-sarf. They could apply them in the Quran and deduce solve many problems. And I just want to finally highlight just two places in Sayfi Chishtiyai where Hazrat Rahimahullah Ta'ala has applied one of the sciences of syntax and ma'ani, eloquence. And that is in the very famous verse of the Quran, وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ يَقِينًا بَلْ رَفَعَهُ اللَّهُ إِلَيْهِ. And this is the verse which pertains the statement of Salb al-Qatl, that Isa alayhi salatu wasalam was not assassinated, was not killed, was not crucified, but rather Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised him to the heavens. Rafa'ahu Allah ilayh. Hazrat rahimahullah ta'ala had from this word which has been used in this ayah, the conjunction bal. Hazrat rahimahullah ta'ala mentioned that this is bal ibtaliya, and then went into more intricate detail and explained through evidences, literal and through eloquence and through the usage of the bal ibtaliya, that the Jesus Isa alayhi salatu wasalam was not slayed as the Jews had thought, that they had slayed Isa alayhi salam on the cross, maz'umul yahud, wama qataluhu bal rafa'ahu Allah alayh. In fact, but rather Allah had raised, rafa'ahu Allah alayh, Allah had raised Jesus Isa alayhi salam to the heavens. This was the reason for this was, in brief, I haven't the time to go into more detail, and just briefly, that the Hazrat Rahimahullah Ta'ala through this bal had explained the truth of the ayah, the true fact of the ayah, and the aqidah of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah from centuries upon centuries, which started from Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and the Sahaba, Tabi'in, Taba Tabi'in, that Rafa'ullah, Isa alayhi salam was raised alive to the heavens. And the word Rafa'a here then would most definitely mean he was raised physically, he was raised to the heavens. And not as Mirza Qadiani had said, that Rafa'a in this ayat is referring to raised in rank, that Rafa'a, he was raised in rank. But all the evidence which Hazrat Rahimahullah Ta'ala through these sciences and through the uloom and fanoon, Hazrat Rahimahullah Ta'ala answered all these arguments and established and proved that the aqaid of Ahli Sunnah or Jamaat from centuries upon centuries is the true aqaid for us to follow. And there's many more examples. Hazrat Rahimahullah Ta'ala highlighted the word tawaffa in the Quran, whereas Mirza Qadiani had said tawaffa, the literal meaning is to die, wafat, whereas Hazrat Rahimahullah Ta'ala through Lughatul Arabiya and through the Mahawaratul Arab, the phraseologies of the usages and istimalat, Hazrat Rahimahullah Ta'ala highlighted through evidences and shawahid of the Quran. For example, Hazrat Rahimahullah Ta'ala mentioned Allahu yatawaffal anfusa hina mawtiha wallati lam tamut fi manamiha فَيُمْسِكُ الَّتِي قَضَى عَلَيْهَا الْمَوْتَى وَيُرْسِلُ الْأُخْرَى إِلَىٰ أَجَلِ مُسَمَّى. In this ayat, Hazrat Rahimahullah Ta'ala mentioned that wafat, the literal meaning of wafat, isn't death, isn't to die, the literal meaning and the haqiqi meaning for what the wafa has been configured for and what has been waza for, the haqiqi meaning, ma wuzi'a lahu, of wafat is to take something completely. And from there, Hazrat Rahmatullah Ta'ala Alayh goes on to explain in depth the so Sefi Chishtiyai, subhanallah, I would advise the scholars of today to study the Sefi Chishtiyai, and inshallah subhanahu wa ta'ala you will find much benefits from this book on this subject. There's probably no other book written better on this subject in this fashion and this style of the scholarly style of method which Hazrat Rahimahullah Ta'ala has used in this book to elaborate the and establish the aqaid of Ahli Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Finally, I'd like to end my talk today, this brief talk, by one of the Urdu couplets of Allama Iqbal Rahimahullah Ta'ala. Hazaron saal nargas apni benuri pe roti hai, badi mushkil se hota hai chaman mein deeda war paida. Allama Iqbal Rahimahullah, in this couplet, he is given as an example of a narcus, a flower which is similar, looks like an eye, and it weeps and laments over its darkness that it can't see. Benuri pe roti hai. And then in the second part of the couplet, Allama Iqbal explains the real intended meaning. Badi mushkil se hota hai chaman mein deedawar paida. A man of vision, deedawar, a man with a vision, God-gifted vision, and one who does a huge work and contribution towards the religion of Islam is born, very rarely does he come after many, many, a long period of time. And Hazrat Rahimah Raisul Mujaddideen Rahimahullah Ta'ala was one of those august personalities, great personalities. Alhamdulillah, we thank Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala that we are connected with them and their offspring. May Allah Ta'ala keep our connection, our nisbat with the great offspring of Raisul Mujaddideen Rahimahullah Ta'ala till the last breath of our lives. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us firm and established on the aqaid of Ahli Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Hazrat Rahimahullah Ta'ala's teachings are in line with the teachings of the Akabirin from 1400 years, the teachings which are coming down, which is continually coming down. This is Sarat-e Mustaqim. And it's this which is mentioned in Surah Al-Fatiha, اِهْدِنَا السَّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ سِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا الضَّالِينَ. O Allah, guide us onto the straight path, the path of those people who you have bestowed upon. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, protect our aqaid. Allah ta'ala, keep us steadfast and firm on the aqaid of Ahli Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Allah ta'ala, make us lovers of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, of the Sahaba, of all the Ahle Bayt-e Kiram. Allah Ta'ala keep us safe. Allah Ta'ala protect us all, and Allah Ta'ala keep us safe and keep us firm and steadfast on the aqaid of Ahle Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Wa ma alayna illa al-balagh al-mubin.